Good morning, everybody. It is Jamie. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. It is Wednesday, though I am nowhere near my regular schedule. I am still coming back gently into the studio. And I have to say, today is a glorious day. The sun is shining, and it must be an unseasonably warm September day, or I'm not feeling as better as I thought I was. Oh my goodness, last night we started back at guitar. We have a really big class in which Jess and I are sitting firmly in the middle of experience, and it really went well. We're focusing on two particular duets, and we're just loving playing duets together. You know, we learn one part and then we learn another part, and then it just feels like magic when we play it together and we start to hear, oh, wait, that's how those pieces go together. Oh, look, that's how those pieces go together. And that is such a joy. Our new assignment is to record ourselves and have a listen. So maybe if it sounds not too shabby, I'll see about sharing. And speaking of sharing, I got a lovely, I just wanted to share with you. Alexis Zinkerman shared this with me. This is Crazy Tragic Magic Life, which is her self-published book that is all, it's a story told in poetry. And so thank you so much, Alexis, for sending that to me. I really appreciate it, and I look forward to diving in. It does deal tenderly and rawly with the loss of a friend, and so I might have to step into it gently, because I still feel very present with the loss of my mom. But thank you so much. And I also, one of the reasons I wanted to show everybody is to encourage you to realize you can make this stuff happen. Look at what Alexis has done. So I'll put a link to her site at the bottom. She wrote me a lovely note at the front. And also, you know, if you want to send me stuff, if you want me to see what you're creating, I always share my post office box in the newsletter. So you can send me stuff there. I also picked up something recently. Did you do with me the art journaling workshop over at Creative Bug with Dawn DeVries Sokol? I really enjoyed it and got a lot out of it, and it's really had me thinking about art journaling. And I was creating all sorts of art journaling pages, and I kept lusting after the art journal that she used. And I had a hard time finding it in any of the stores around me. When I looked on Amazon, I found it very expensive. But then I found that Desair sold it for $26. And anything over $25 was free shipping. And so I went for it. So here it is. It is a Strathmore mixed media hardcover journal. And it's 64 pages. You can see about how thick it is. And it's a hardcover. It's a little soft, so I keep kind of fondling it. And the thing that's wonderful about it, it's like real heavy mixed media paper inside. And one of the things I thought too, because I know $26 can still feel like an investment for a journal, but if you do art journaling, you know, like you spend a lot of time on each of these pages. Like it could take me, I imagine it'll take me a year to finish this up, unless I get obsessive, which could mean like it'll be done by next week. I'm just kidding. But so I think that's, I often do that when I'm thinking about investing. I think about, well, how long is this going to be a part of my life? How long is it going to provide entertainment or education or usefulness? I mean, there'll be the time that I'm creating in it, and then well past then, there'll be the time I turn back and enjoy it. And so I'm not suggesting that you necessarily need to go out and pick up a Strathmore Mixed Media Journal. What I'm suggesting is that when something tugs at your heart, like this tugged at mine, really think about whether you can give yourself the gift of the precise thing that you're yearning for. And speaking of art journaling, 21 Secrets is just around the corner. And I'm so excited to share my class with you, Seven Soul Symbols. And again, part of that, for me, the whole motivation was helping people find their own symbolic expression, to find those signature archetypal numbers, animals, shapes, colors that are you, that speak to and from you. So I'm always looking for that place where we can share and be grounded in a basic structure and support, but then that's a springboard for us discovering and sharing our unique gifts. And so I hope you'll check it out. Connie is doing a beautiful thing for the next, she started yesterday, so for 10 days, she is doing art journal wisdom lessons on her blog, totally free, and you don't have to sign up for anything. You just get to go to Dirty Footprint Studio and see the lesson, and then the next one, but it will make you feel grounded and help you discover whether art journaling is something that you want to discover some more of. I'll also be recording the podcast at the end of this week, so if you have a question for me that you'd like me to answer, send it along to jamie@openthedoor.ca. I'm hearing myself get gravelly, so I'm going to head out and get into my day. Today I'm going to do a whole bunch of writing, and I think I'm going to make a start on the Full Hunter's Moon Dream Board Workshop, because today, yep, it's the new moon. So maybe that'll be a magical time to start, even though it's a magical time that I usually share. Being open to flow and change is a part of creative life. Have a great day in your studio, and I will be back with you again tomorrow morning. Bye.